All right, folks, looks like we're gonna start now. First of all, thank you for coming. My name is Roman Martin. I'll be walking you through the enterprise COE enablement. I know you had about 100 other sessions you probably could have gone to, so I really appreciate you taking the time and coming to this one. Before we get started, I kind of wanted to gauge the room a bit. How many people are on the business side? We have our business analysts, reporting analysts, measurements. All right. Technology, we have any technology folks here? The enablers, thank you. Have any architects? What, no, just designing solutions? All right, so let's keep architect. We'll talk, I'll say everything I wanna say about the architects in this session. thanks again, so let's kick this off. We're gonna go through kind of the why. We've implemented the COE, Tableau, and overall data and analytics. We'll talk about Tableau at TD, the growth over the years, the different COE pillars, the type of work we do to support our community. We'll talk about a subject that really is near and dear to my heart, because something that, while Tableau plays an important role, and we often do this using Tableau, this is really Tableau agnostic, and it's really changing your reporting paradigm. And then I'll touch on the different tools of the trade that we have developed at TD to make sure that we support our community the best way we can. So without further ado, my name is Roman Martin. I lead the TD's Tableau as well as SaaS COE. Any SaaS users? All right, here we go. The conference, the SaaS conferences compared to Tableau, I just got shivers thinking about last year's SaaS conference. So for those folks, just to reiterate, I think this is a really good definition. COE is a team, a shared facility, or an entity that provides leadership, best practice, research, in support and training for a focus area. This is my LinkedIn if you want to connect. And if you have been following Ken Flerlange? He posted some really cool stuff with Tableau. So this is LumArt. I don't know if you ever looked at doing LumArt using Tableau. It's neat. It's one of those things that it's really hard to find uses for it. So I try to stick it anywhere I can. But it's a really neat thing. So who are we? So the center is five folks. Four of them are here. And we support all these different pillars. So we're kind of the central point between all of the line of businesses using TD, our technology partners, they're supporting the infrastructure, all the communication with the architects around solutioning, as well as the anything Tableau related with the vendor. So there's at this point, there's nothing really happening with Tableau at TD that we either don't know about or don't influence. Now, TD overall. Everybody hopefully knows what TD Bank is. It's one of the oldest banks in North America. It started off, I think, 1862. Since it's a composition of multiple banks that have merged over the years, it's kind of hard to say exactly where you started. I think it's 1862 with the Portland Savings Bank that then became Bank North, and then there's a Bank of Toronto that opened in 1865. But overall, it's just wealth of experience really around financial industry, innovation and growth. And speaking really of growth, this is a couple of snapshots. In the beginning of 2000s, we were at around 42,000 employees. We were primarily a Canadian bank. Since then, and this slide is slightly outdated, but we're over 90,000 employees across both Canada and the Eastern Seaboard in US, as well as the offices in UK and Singapore and other places. So I want to touch on why we started on this journey, why we built the COE. And I want to go back to 2016, where we said, you know what, let's figure out who our data and analytics professionals are, the kind of work that they do, where they spend most of their time, and let's see if there are some opportunities that we can address. Because at the end of the day, we might be a bank, and then you know, you might be healthcare, or an insurance company, or automotive. But at the end of the day, we're all data companies, right? And then the amount of budget that's being spent on data and analytics is just staggering. And the more we go down that path, the more we're gonna be more and more data company first, and then the financial services and the customer services provider second. So we went out and we looked at all of the people who did analytics. First of all, it was a huge eye-opener. We realized we have 91 teams across the organization that consider themselves analytical teams. And that's insane. That's like 1,700 people who are in analytical data roles, who are extremely educated in data and analysis and really drive that the data storytelling for their particular team or particular pillar. And when we took a look at what those people were doing, our first opportunity jumped out at us right away. We noticed that about 30% of your day as a data analyst was prepping data. Like it's 30% of your highly skilled analysts of their day, they spend extracting stuff, making sure it conforms to certain standards, journeying to other sources, making it usable, and only then did they go into some basic standard reporting around the data, your Excels, with a really your visualization, BI reporting, and more advanced analytical functions being just a fraction of their workday. And it's a huge problem. You know, we're paying, like we're talking about what, 100,000 hours a week? 30,000 of that being spent on just data wrangling? No, it's a big issue. So having seen that, TD said, you know, enough is enough. We're gonna make sure that we're a data-driven organization and we're gonna put the right amount of focus, the right amount of budget, and the right structure behind it as well. So first, it is just not just Tableau. First they said, okay, looks like data and the data wrangling is an issue. We have all these disparate sources, like thousands of data sources across the bank, and we have people who reporting same things using different methods and often actually reporting, trying to report the same metric but getting different results. Makes us look pretty bad. So one of the first biggest commitments that TD has made was implementing a lake, so a Hadoop ecosystem with the goal that over the next few years, well, few is a relative term, over the next short while, we're gonna centralize most of the sources that TD uses in this lake. We're gonna model it, we're gonna conform it, we're gonna build the metadata, integrate it, and finally put it in a place where it can be easily consumable by all the analytical teams using the platform. Second part with that was, okay, so now we have a vision for the overall data strategy. We're gonna move it here. Now there's gonna be a little sandbox associated with all of this where analysts and reporting teams will be able to get at that data. And we need a tool that's gonna be easy to use, easy to learn, that's gonna tell these really impactful stories. After a number of different POCs, Tableau fighting with SSRS and Cognos and all the Power BI coming in and saying, yeah, you take it for free, you know, like just take it, just use it. We said, no, it looks like the tool of choice for us for this particular capability is Tableau. And that was in 2016. Since then, we have been spending quite a bit of efforts building out the COE, and I'll touch on that, as well as building out the overall infrastructure for the ecosystem. That's called the Integrated Data and Analytics, or now it's called Acora Ecosystem. Now, how did Tableau get into TD in the first place? Probably the same way Tableau got into your company as well. Somebody somewhere, business analyst, working with a lot of data, tried Tableau, really liked it, was blown away by how easy it is to start building these powerful visualizations, and bought a license, then another license. And then they showed it to somebody else, and they bought a license too. So we started with Tableau in 2011. It was a smattering of desktop licenses, primarily in the US. Over the next few years, a couple of servers popped up as well. There's one server in the US that was for the commercial line of business, and one in Canada, specifically to drive the adoption for OCIO. Now, by 2016, when we realized that we need a capability to do this, and we selected Tableau, and we built the COE, we looked back and we realized that there are already about 400 developers across the bank. And nobody, well, few teams knew of each other, but on the large, they really didn't know that there were other people building Tableau solutions using even sometimes same data as they are, as they do. So we established the COA in 2016, and we started off with centralizing everything Tableau. We said, okay, all of the keys, all of this individual management, reached out to Tableau, said stop, like just stop. I know you want to sell 13 desktop licenses to an audit team in US, just sell it to us, we'll figure out a way to charge the money back, put in a single portal, and we'll track it through that. We said, okay, this is crazy. We now have hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of developers, and all of them are managing individual keys. Let's stop that. Let's figure out a way how to implement a single desktop key. Still haven't been implemented, but we're working on it. So what happened, if you were into key management and license management, things like that, you know the challenge, right? So your individual desktop keys have the maintenance expiry dates aligned to the date of when the key was sold, right? So if you have 1,500 keys, you have keys renewing every single week, pretty much. And just getting a single key to get it implemented was gonna be hell. There's no company, like internally, people said there's no way finance is gonna figure out how much to charge and charge back, and Tableau said, charge back, we don't give money back. So we went back and said, okay, listen, we'll make it our problem, and my team probably hated me for it for about a year. But what we did, we reached out to every single license holder across the bank and said, we just got a really good price with Tableau, prepaid your next maintenance to March of 2020, and it's gonna be the same price as you would have renewed anyway. So over a year later, since that point, we're all aligned now. Everybody's expiring on the same day. But if you're looking for a single enterprise key, that's one of the first considerations you'll need before even moving to it. So we're all lined up. I think next time we do a server upgrade, we'll also package the enterprise key as part of that as well. In 2017, we signed this master agreement with Tableau, where we said, okay, give us a really nice preferred rate on the server purchases, on all the server licenses, as well as give us all these provisions for desktop and all the other stuff. This is where the enterprise server came to be. This is a 48-core implementation. I'll touch on it in a second. And at present, it's a high availability with lower environments that supports about 5,000 consumers or so. And then 2019, we're here today. We're at 2,500 active server users weekly. We're at over 1,500 desktop keys. We're finally centralizing a whole bunch of individual platforms that we have across TD, and we're working with Tableau on an uplift plan for an additional 30,000 consumers. And if you wanna talk about the licensing and the enterprise scale licensing, and if you already have, let's say, core perpetual, and you wanna switch to a role base and some of the challenges you might have with it, my Tableau reps are over there, so I have to be really careful about what I say. But come talk to me, because it's not a very straightforward kind of like shut this off and turn this on, right? So a lot of considerations. And I know at some point, since a lot of the implementations have already been done using perpetual licenses, a lot of the times you'll be faced with doing just that, switching a license model. Okay, so server infrastructures. I'll talk quickly about the little 8-core sandbox we have. Was the first one in Canada. I mentioned there was another one in the US. This one, pretty much anybody who wanted to try anything Tableau, we brought them on board, put them there, and said, okay, we have some guidelines. Make sure you don't break those guidelines, but do whatever you want. Bring your own data, do your POCs, really drive the engagement of Tableau. We had our wrists slapped by Trimis and compliance and other teams quite a few times on that. But the thing is, I'm on the business side. What that means is that if I have an actual team that drives actual business value from Tableau, that is gonna trump anything. We're gonna figure out a way to make sure that they can do their work at the same time while working with all of the control partners to make sure that that we build out the right framework going forward. And then we have the enterprise Tableau server, the 48 core that's soon to be, I don't know, 220 something ridiculous. We launched it at the end of 2017, has around 50 sites today. If you remember the analytics survey, we have 91 teams, have 50 sites already on the server, and we're only in our second year of driving the adoption for Tableau. It's a high availability environment, has lower environments associated with it, et cetera. Now, I've touched upon that on this already. We really are, so these are all the different pillars of what we do. We're your face between line of business and the vendor, the technology partners who are supporting our platforms, and the community. So in 2016, when we started this work, we had around 450 or so developers across North and South. We're at over 1,500 now. And the team grew from 4 people to 5 people. So the scale did not really catch up yet, but it will. And the reason why we do what we do, I'll touch on it when we talk about tools, is really around getting really good at process management and building processes that really help us go through all that volume of intake and then really address all of the other capabilities. On the community front, there's an open mailbox that any question you have Tableau related, go through that. We provide advice, we provide training, we've developed a pretty robust curriculum of kind of university type 101, 201, 301 level sessions that we host every couple of weeks. Well, mostly once a week, but some of them more often than that. And then resources. If you ever need anything Tableau related, you come to us, we'll point you in the right direction. This is just a bit more about, so we establish best practices, create special sessions, develop proof of concepts. This is something that I would like to do more of. You'll see when we start talking about centralized support, you'll see the volume of really intake questions, et cetera, around triaging the mailbox. In fact, I think I see Catherine over there trying to log into the mailbox right now. And really just build out the support model around the sites, right? How we onboard people, the roles and responsibilities, things like that. And at the end of the day, we're the promoters of Tableau. Like, the success of the community is our success. And we do anything possible to make sure that your team, if they would like to use Tableau for your visualization needs, that you have an opportunity to do that. We use connections. Probably you have something similar. This is our one-stop shop for anything Tableau. There is server side, and there is the desktop side. There's the forum, the calendar of events, and your intake portal as well. There's a SharePoint site. We develop quite a bit of sessions around best practices and exercises. People love exercises, and some of the things we would do is we would pick a type of visualization. I don't know, let's take a Sankey. Everybody loves Sankeys. I think you have to, there's like a graduation check somewhere from beginner to an intermediate where you're like, have you built a Sankey? Yes. You know, all right, intermediate. So what we did was, for example, for a Sankey, we built a framework for it using our own dummy data. Then we posted on our SharePoint and really challenged the community to use their own data and our kind of walkthroughs to make sure that they can build something similar. And some of the stuff coming back was really neat. Like, it's you never really expect teams to show that much analytical talent in the areas where you historically haven't, like, there hasn't been a huge dedicated analytical team, right? Like, so real estate, for example, came back and said, listen, check this out. We took your Sankey diagram, we looked at our data, and you know how you tap your pass every time you go between floors, between buildings? Here's our complete volume of people moving across all of our assets, right? And I'm like, okay, that's cool. But going back to that Lumart, how is it useful? You know, they're like, well, no, next step, we can actually use that in flex time planning to make sure that we know the volumes coming into the floors. I'm like, aha, now that's cool. You know, it's not enough to just build a Sankey, but the way you use it is amazing. And anything shows like relatively basic flows, Sankeys is great. Training. Tableau is a fantastic, easy to learn. If you're a self-trainer, if you'll enjoy just training on your own pace, my God, you're probably an expert by now, because the amount of information available to you is just ridiculous. Anything from, you know, the community, the makeover Mondays, the workout Wednesdays, if you want to learn, there's an opportunity for you to learn. Now, if you're more into kind of structured, instructor-led, we do that too. So we have our sessions. We partner with Tableau and other companies in the area to do classroom sessions as well. Or if you want to learn more structurally, but also on your own, there's, I don't know, you guys use e-learning modules from Tableau? Like the $350 ones that give you Tableau 1, 2, and 3 for a year? That's really cool. So If you haven't looked at it, check it out. It's a pretty powerful thing. We're also partnering with Tableau now on something called Skill Belts. I don't know if you have talked to your Tableau partners about that, your success partners. But if you haven't, you know, it's an interesting idea where it's almost like internal certification. It's not gonna, well, kind of gonna prep you for taking your desktop certifications, but it's really more internal. So we're gonna create a belt, call it the green belt, and in order for you to reach a green belt, here's like 7 different things you need to know and do and prove that you can do it to get the belt, right? And you'll be able to, some bit of a gamification, points, and all the good stuff. Now, this is something I wanted to touch on. It's, as I mentioned, it's not really, it's Tableau specific because we use Tableau for this, but really it's more around how you're telling your data stories, right? How many times did you have somebody come to you and say, okay, I heard about Tableau, Tableau is great, here's my Excel spreadsheet, I have 350,000 rows, it's great, it tells me all the stories I need. Well, I kind of tell my own story, but it's, the data is there, it's great, build me this, right? And how many times people actually went ahead and built Excel spreadsheets in Tableau? That's, yeah, every time I see that, I'm like getting heart palpitations. Anyway, so the good thing is that this is a very poorly performing viz. You know, the table is horrible. You know, the amount of marks on the screen is just ridiculous. And because we're really good at monitoring the performance of all the dashboards, we come to you, Catherine, we come to you and say that your viz sucks, I'm sorry. You know, it's slow. Like, what were you thinking? Why did you build this? Seriously, have you not gone to any of the sessions? Like, what? And a lot of the times people come back and go, I'm not a visual person. You know, it's last 15 years, I've used Excel. I'm used to rows and columns. I don't know how to, well, apparently make a pie chart. the good thing about that is we identify you early on. And it's a proactive, so it's a proactive communication. A lot of the times when your stuff doesn't perform, when your other platforms, you set off a red flag somewhere, you probably, if you have really good process, there's a warning notification that goes saying your stuff doesn't perform, you have 2 weeks, get it into pad otherwise, et cetera. What we do is different. We go and say, your stuff doesn't perform, here's like 5 things you can do to make it perform. Let's set up some time, let's go through it, let's figure it out, right? Have you thought about, you know, using fewer quick filters or whatever the particular challenge might be for that dashboard? At the end of the day, we do get somewhere that's way better, more effective, and impactful at telling those stories. Some of the tools of the trade. So 5 people supporting 1,500 developers across, I think, around 70 teams. So 50 are on the server, 20 are still in the queue. It takes, like, we have to be really, really good at process. Every single process, whether it's onboarding, whether it's troubleshooting, whether it's monitoring, everything is documented as much as automation as possible. We centralized all support into a single mailbox, similar to, like, I want everybody in every single line of business in TD to think, okay, I have a Tableau problem. That Tableau should trigger an email into our Tableau COE, that, hey, here's what's happening or not happening, and I want it to happen. We triage it, and then we go from there. And we're really, really good at leveraging Postgres and doing performance reporting metrics that are available to all of you. So if you're on the server, if you're administering the server, and you're not leveraging Postgres, shame on you. You should be. That's a disservice to everybody who's using the platform, because they need to know what performs, what doesn't perform, how well it does or doesn't, et cetera. We've implemented roles. There's governance roles. Every time we set up a site, we want to make sure we don't just identify a site admin or something like that. No, there's an owner, there's a security manager. The security manager makes the decisions around your Active Directory groups, who goes in, who goes out. By the way, Active Directory groups, if you talk about role-based licensing, really dig into Active Directory groups. We have data stewards, so we want to make sure that we don't just bring, let's say, I don't know, Trimis or internal audit or marketing on board and let them publish whatever they want. No, we have a clear data roadmap that goes, at some point in the future, all your data, all the sources are gonna be in this cluster. Until that is the case, we're giving you a platform where you can bring your own data, but you're gonna document the hell out of it. You wanna have a data steward that knows every single data connection that you're using and documents it. And for that, we've built even more Tableau dashboards. Let's say here's a site that has USMA spots, I think, Christian. That's your site, isn't it? See how green that whole pillar is right there on the right? That means they've documented all of their sources. That's fantastic. Way to go. Thanks, Christian. but yeah, we have to be constantly on the teams, and we try to centralize that, try to figure out a way to become experts in all the data sources, and it just doesn't work. You have to make sure the onus is on the line of business to do this work. And it's also gonna benefit them down the road, right? When it's time to actually do the ingestion of all their data sources into the Hadoop ecosystem, they're gonna be asked for metadata. And they're gonna be asked to explain and integrate all that data. Now they have it, it's all documented. Speed is a big thing. If you're managing platforms and you don't have a tenant agreement with your site owners, get one. Trust me, even though everybody is supposed to be using best practices and developing things that you want them to develop, they don't. And things like, here's our SLA for performance from you. So anything you publish in our lower environments has to be sub 10 seconds. I don't care what your data source is. I don't care if you're trying to query 9 billion records, sub 10 seconds. Now you can come back to me and say, no, that's ridiculous. Like, seriously, you want Hive to query 9 billion row table and get us something in 10 seconds? It's impossible, right? I challenge you. Come back to us, say, yeah, no, it's impossible. Let us figure out if it is or isn't. Because somebody came back last year and said, no, this is impossible. We took a look at tools and said, okay, well, AtScale says they can do it. Let's put AtScale in between all the Hive tables and then Tableau. We're still trying to make sure they can do it. It's been a long journey, but I'm sure that we'll figure it out. But this is an open communication between us and every single developer, every line of business. It's like we want to make sure there are no there's no rumors flying around. Oh, this is too expensive, or no, this is too restrictive, or it's too slow, etc. If you think it is, come to us. We'll either bust it, or we're going to use it as an opportunity to get better. Further on the governance as well, we have a lot of automated dashboards running on Postgres. Honestly, learn Postgres, fantastic. And we also approached tracking of all of our intake in the same fashion, right? We make sure everything's templated, all your requests coming through a single portal. We classify it based on the type of request that comes in. And yeah, if you really wrap yourself in processes that are efficient. So last year, between the five of us, well, I'll take myself out of this because I don't do as much triage as I probably should. Between the four people, we went through 12,000 requests. And it's massive. Like, it's, show me kind of another mailbox system that can not only respond to requests, but actually help solve an issue within most of our, we don't have a strict SLA in terms of solving an issue, but most of it is solved within 24 hours. Okay, sessions. Hugely important. We build a calendar, integrate it into Tableau. Yay, go us. Yeah, all of this, like, why are we doing this? Well, we're doing it because of these folks here, because of the 1,500 developers in the community, because of 50 people from TD who are here today, you know, attending the conference. And everybody is passionate. Everybody is an expert in their field, and they want to use our tools to really get to that wow moment, to really just get enjoyment and excitement out of the data that they're using. And when you work with a very passionate team like that, trust me, they will let you know as well. So every year I reach out to the entire community and like, hey, it's year end, we're getting ready for conversations. Give me some of the feedback, good or bad, regardless of what it is. And feedback they give. And be very careful what you ask, because they give all the good, they give all the bad, which is fantastic, actually, I love it. Being a bit of a data junkie, I threw it in a work cloud. And you see that not only do you see like great team and help, you see things like versions and licenses and technology, right? Like, So it's the things that we know is in our roadmap to fix, and it's really helping us to build out the path for the next few years. And I have to do this. So if you were at this morning's spotlight and you got Adam's speech, Julia on the team has built that. She was participating in the feeder for the Iron Vest. And I know this was a huge moment for Julie and for the team. And I know that it's only a matter of time until she's on stage at the Iron Viz, and then just living and breathing everything Tableau in front of everybody. This is it for me. I will take any questions. We have some time. Do we have mics? Do we have mics? I don't know. You want to project? I'll repeat the question. Or no, we have a mic. Thanks. Literally, just go ahead.
Check 1, 2.
Hi. I'm Swain with Nike. I'm fascinated by this idea of your 10-second limit. I'm curious about the implementation of that. I mean, I run the enterprise platform at Nike. We get people who would commonly claim that they get lots of good business value out of a 30-second dashboard, and so we've been very hesitant to put in some kind of an ironclad absolute number as an SLA. So I'm curious about your journey getting that done. I mean, what's the virtue of doing that versus describing performance maybe in a different way?
Yeah, it's a good question. So we start off with knowing exactly what we can manage per 8 course, right? We know the performance. If we do sub 10 second with the volume that we're getting, we can support, let's say, 1,000 developers or publishers per 8 course, which is about double of what Tableau recommends to do per that environment. There's a value component to it. The justification of a value is always difficult. If they're able to come back to you and say, here is the benefit, that clearly articulated benefit of having a 10-second dashboard versus a 30-second dashboard. To us, it's server implementation, server resources. You can argue the fact that your dashboard has to perform at 30 seconds and you can show actual value out of it. Well, listen, you know, it's put in place to make sure that we can govern the platform effectively. But if we need to change that, there's always an opportunity for that as well. It, like you said, it's driven by the value. At the end of the day, if I would still like to make sure that they can get the same value out of the sub 30 seconds, but if the case is the case, then we would take a look at it. In the last 2 years, we haven't had really somebody coming back to us and saying that.
Would you also,
With your transparent performance metrics that you publish, would you just talk to those real quick? Like, which ones do you make widely available to people, and talk about those a little bit?
Yeah, so those are specifically around the individual rendering performance of the dashboard. There's a nice bubble chart by time and by dates for each individual site, so that they can see the degradation performance if it starts happening, right? So they kind of get ahead of it. Because data changes, underlying data can change, and then it's only a matter of time. Like, to us, in order for us to be effective, we have to be really strict and knowing exactly what's happening on the platform. And those metrics, specifically around the individual performances. Like, if you want, afterwards, I'll show you the bubbles. Thanks.
Thank you for your presentation. My name is Robert. I work also at a bank, Rabobank, in the Netherlands. What I'm interested in is, let's say, the problem that I face is that senior management is still in the PDF level and give me a bar chart and How do you address that point? Is it still PDF and give me a bar chart and a pie chart and instead of all, yeah, what I'm a probably eight-year user of Tableau. And
yeah.
I say, the data shows you the insight. How did you address that problem?
So one of the effective ways for us to do that, it's really, again, just changing the way people consume the information. One of the things that really worked well for us was we set up our internal competitions. What we do is across the bank, we partner with a line of business. They give us their, you know, it reporting data set. We mask the hell of it so that nobody can trace it down to a customer level of detail. And then we engage the community and say, okay, so here's the data set that we have. It's a, let's say, an audit data set or project management office data set. Let's figure out a way, the best way to tell stories out of that data. And we get those senior executives to be the judges at the last kind of the top five finalists. So just last week, was it last week, week before, we did the one partnering with team that does project management expenses, finance. And you know finance, we need our financial charts. They're specific. This is exactly what we want. They literally were going to some of our finalists and going, hey, you want a job in finance? You know, this is, because it starts with, so you can show them the way, you can do it bottom up. Alternatively, partner with Tableau. Tableau does something where they get a whole bunch of executives in a room, lock the door, give them Tableau desktop and some facilitator and say, okay, here's your own data. Let me show you how to do things with Tableau. And usually after they see the dynamic side of it, they don't often go to PDFs. Like we have our branch banking, reporting folks that do metric performance. Historically, you know, your SSRS picture perfect, pixel perfect, print ready reports, they're now on mobile, right? Like, because now they have the tools and they have the executives that have seen the power of Tableau, what it can do, drive those requirements. That it's a change, right? Like that's the thing. It's how to implement the change is tricky, but there are a number of different approaches you can tackle it. Good questions.
I have a related question. Right here.
Oh, hey.
Yeah, my name's Kingsley. I just started working at a small loan servicer. And we're doing some banking activities as well. But my issue is I was brought in to work on the analytics side, mm-hmm. and all of the data, including the data collection, it's not very good. And I don't think that the individuals who are in the business line, the front-facing, like picking up a phone and taking payments, I don't think they're ever going to care about mm-hmm. the quality of the data. And they're never going to get excited about using Excel and making tables. So I would imagine at a larger organization, you came up against the same issue where you have the bank teller who's in a position to collect data,
yep.
but isn't really interested in it. So how would you overcome that?
I would look at two things. One, automate as much of the data collection as possible. Just make the system as simple and as intuitive so that people who just put boxes, fill boxes, et cetera. Two, make it a part of their performance reviews. Like, I know. Not just performance reviews, but compensation, right? Like, so if I'm an employee at the branch and I care about loan sales or amount of loans or the term and things like that, unless I provide accurate data, then every loan that I sell is part of my target and then my compensation, right? Just make it either super simple where it's so transparent, people don't even know they're doing data collection, or make them really care about doing that. And then when you make it really like care, they start gaming, and then you get to learn about the gaming and reverse the gaming. It's really cool. Thanks. Any other questions? All right. Yeah. No. That was, I don't know if I should say. So I used the trial version of Alteryx, and and I fed all the stuff through it. So, and
it's
Alteryx says.
Alteryx, because I'm trying to do something similar, yeah. where, but right now I'm using a Python script to like get an email done and then connecting that to Outlook.
Actually, talk to Catherine. Catherine, haven't you been trying to do that through a Python script as well? Yeah. All right. Thanks. Look at that. The COE is now expanding globally. We are at 4 minutes until 3. Unless there are any other questions? Oh, one more question. Last question.
Are there other centers of excellence within the bank, maybe for data engineering or the data lake that you mentioned, and is that how you kind of interact with those groups?
Yep. So this entire pillar of enterprise data and analytics that was set up 2 years ago, it comes with your business platform owners. Those platform owners are your centers of excellence. Like we have an ingestion center, right? If you want to figure out the best and the fastest and the cheapest way to ingest your data into the cluster, you talk to these people. Not to the same extent that we have done for Tableau or for SAS, but it's only a matter of time. So that organization is relatively young and then still being built out. But the plan is, as you go into this ecosystem, every single either platform asset or a tool that's being leveraged is going to have a center back in it as well. Make sense? All right, I think this is it. Thank you very much for coming. Enjoy the rest of your conference. Thank you.